So welcome. Now we will enter into unit number 3, okay, reactive power control. Okay. So reactive power control, in this we will see how to control the voltage, okay, voltage control methods and HVDC, okay, at the end. So there are two topics in this unit. One is voltage control and second one is HVDC. Okay. So before we go to how to control the reactive power, we will establish relation between reactive power and real power. Okay. So this is a generator which is supplying power to some consumers. Okay. So they are receiving in voltage is V, angle left it is zero. I am assuming this as a reference voltage. And this is at some angle delta, and there is a reactive power reactance of the transmission line. I am neglecting resistance. So if I apply KVL, then I got voltage Vs angle delta minus voltage Vr angle zero divided by Ax. Okay. So this is the current flowing through this transmission line. Now what is power? No? And this is per phase. Okay. I have drawn per phase circuit. Okay. But in actual power system there are 3 phase. Okay. So at the end you have to multiply power by 3 factor. So just I am doing for per phase basis. So what is power? You know complex power in AC system, S is the complex power, or we can say complex power. S equal to B I conjugate. Okay. We will always take B I conjugate, okay, to account the power factor angle. That's why we will put conjugate here. Now we are finding power at receiving end. Okay. So this is what at receiving end power, SR. We are taking voltage of VR into current entering to the receiving end, and that is I. I is current coming at this receiving end. Now put the value of VR. VR is what? VR is VR magnitude angle zero. Okay. So this is what these VR, VR, VS are the magnitude. Is magnitude angle zero, then put the current. So this is what I can also write. This is Vs angle delta minus Vr angle zero divided by x angle 90 degree, okay, or pi by 2. Okay. This is a complex number. You can write complex number by 1 magnitude angle 90 degree. You know from complex number a plus jb, this form. Okay, if this a is 0 and j is 1, then what is angle? Tan inverse b by a. This can be written tan inverse b is 1, a is 0. So this is pi by 2, okay, or 90 degree. Pi by 2 radian or 90 degree. Same way I can write here. Now I put this value. So Vs is what? Vs angle delta minus Vr angle zero divided by x angle 90 degree. Okay. And it's a conjugate. So here Vs, Vr, x are the magnitudes, and their angle are written in angle form. Okay, that is in polar form. This is what Vr. Okay. And if you are in angle, so how to write angle? Cos theta plus j sin theta. This is the polar form. This is Cartesian form. So this you know left from 10 plus 2. So if I put conjugate side, then magnitude will not affect. because if you are take conjugate of real number, it is always a real number, and if you will take conjugate of angle, then it will become minus. Okay, from complex number you know, okay? If there is a some point, okay, like this, this its value is b, and this point is a plus b, okay, and this is imaginary axis and this is real axis, okay, from z plane. If you want to find the angle, suppose this angle is theta, okay, if you will take conjugate of this number, then what is the conjugate of this number? A minus jb, okay. So where is a minus jb? A is this and minus jb is just below of b, okay. This is minus jb, this is jb. What is this angle? This angle will become minus theta, okay, because we are moving towards clockwise direction, then angle is negative. If we are moving anti clockwise direction, then angle is positive. So I am writing this angle negative. This is what BS magnitude of, if you are taking conjugate of this, then it is itself a magnitude, and this is minus delta, in minus VR, angle 0 we can write or not, it doesn't matter. In X, angle minus 90. If you are simplify it, then what is this? VR by X bracket mein VS angle 90 minus delta minus dr angle 90. How you can open this? By simply this rule. This angle can be replaced by cos theta plus j sin theta, similarly this angle. So do this exercise. So I am getting SR. What is SR? VR divided by X. I can write this cos theta plus j sin theta. VS magnitude bracket mein cos 90 minus delta plus j sin Similarly, we can write this BR minus BR in bracket theta is comes cos theta plus j sin theta. Okay, so cos 90 plus j sin 90. Now this is the expression. Now we will simplify it. This is BR divided by X bracket mein BS. You know what is the cos 90 minus theta is what? Sin theta. Okay. Plus J. This is what? Cos minus BR cos 0, cos 90 is 0, and this is what, 0 plus A 1. Now we will further simplify it, and what we are getting? We are getting BR BS by X sin delta, okay. I multiply this inside, plus BR by X in bracket, and there is also I am taking J outside, okay. So this is what BR by X taking this, this is what B cos delta minus 1. Sorry, cos delta minus So this is what BR. Simply I multiply this inside, then take J comma from here both. Okay, I'm getting this. Now we will simplify this also. This is what SR, or you can write SR is what complex power. So this is PR plus J QR. So if you compare real and imaginary parts, so this is real part and this is also real part. What is PR? PR is VR PS X sin delta. What is QR? Imaginary part is this. Here is this imaginary part. What is QR? QR is what? VR by X bracket VS. The VS. VS cos delta minus VR. Okay. So these two equations you are getting. So this is what a simple sinusoidal quantity. So this is what, when this PR is maximum, then delta equal to 90 degree. Okay, so what is PR max? PR max VR VS by X, this amount. Okay, this value is maximum when delta equal to 90. In that case, sin, the value of this is maximum value is what? 1. Similarly, what is the maximum value of this? 90. Okay. What is this? This will come minus VR by X, negative value. Okay. Now we will analyze how this Q will change. Okay. So we are only concentrated only Q. So when Q is maximum, when this value is maximum, and this value is maximum only when this cos theta will have maximum value. So what is the maximum value of cos theta? 1. Then what is the value of delta? 0. So for maximum Q, delta should be 0. If delta is 0, approximately 0 or very small, then you can say PR is approximately 0, because you know sin 0 is 0. And if you have put delta 0 here, then you are getting QR equal to VR by X VS minus VR. Because I put delta equal to 0, so cos 0 is 1. So this is the value. So this is approximate Q. So from here we can see this VS and VR, VS minus VR is what? Change in voltage, or we can say voltage deviation. So at the terminal, if VR is constant, then we can say reactive power is directly proportional to VS minus VR. Because this is fixed quantity, this will not change. X will not change of the transmission line. Only we can change the voltage between these two terminals. Okay. Then this QR is approximately equal to VS minus VR. Okay. So if you are changing voltage, then we can change. Reactive power. Okay, so this is what receiving in power. Okay. Now what is sending in power? Q sending in, nothing but Q receiving in. Okay. So if you are interested to find Q, okay, and this can also be written in another format. If you are multiplying, this is what P max minus VR by X. So this is a combination. Second is what? QR can also written as VR DS by X cos delta.
Okay. If you multiply this inside,
okay, minus VR square by X. So this is what? Is it P max cos delta minus VR square by X. So in this form, expression can also be written.
Now we are plotting on XY plane, okay, to see the effect of power angle, or we can say delta. Delta is what? Power angle or torque angle. So now we will see the graph. Let this is what P, this is delta. Okay. I am considering only positive part. Okay. So P equal to P max sin delta. We can write this is PR equal to PR max sin delta. Okay. This is what PR max sin delta. This value is 5/2 or 90 degree, and this is what P max or PR max. Okay. Now what about QR? So if you are writing about QR, okay, so when QR is maximum, now you can write in this expression. When delta equal to zero, then what is this? E max minus VR square by X. And delta equal to 90, then this is what? Delta equal to 90. Negative. Okay. So I am writing this in terms of receiving in power. Okay. So what is QS? QS is nothing but minus QR. Okay. So if you are placing minus, then this term comes first. Okay. What is this? VR square by X minus P max cos delta. So if delta equal to zero, then we are getting VR square by X minus delta. Okay. Some value. Or we can say, we can also simplify it little bit. Okay. What is this? If I little bit simplify it, what is QS? VR square by X minus VR VS by X cos delta. If I will take ds dr by x common, okay, and this is what is the left here, VR by VS minus cos delta. Okay. This expression I am getting. Right? If I will take this term common, then whole term will come this here, and I will take VR as common. So VR is left, one VR is left, and then we are multiplying VS, so we are dividing VS. We are getting this. Okay. Let these are the per unit values. Okay. Voltage VR, magnitude of VR equal to magnitude of VS. Okay. In that case, what is this? This is what?
P max 1 minus cos delta. Okay. So now put x delta equal to 0. So 1 minus 1 is 0. Then delta equal to 90. Then this is P max. So it's a graph comes like that. And this is what? Pi, or we can say 180 degree. If you have put 180 degree here, then it is minus 1. So these are 2 times P max. The P max, it comes to be 2 times P max. So this is the profile of PR and QR with respect to angle, power angle delta. So are you getting this? This is what? This is the graph of QR equal to minus QR, or minus QR equal to QS. Yeah, reactive power. So from here we can see reactive power will depend upon delta. If delta is large, the reactive power requirement is large, but it is less sensitive with respect to delta. Okay? It is more sensitive with respect to voltage. Okay? So with this figure, we can analyze Q is directly proportional to Vs minus Vr. Okay? It's a magnitude. So this is P max value. This is a graph of PR. So this is the expression and governing representation of power profile with respect to power angle. Okay. We will see how to change this BR and BS. Okay. Or we can say how to increase this power by reducing this Q. So our objective is how to reduce Q and we can increase P. Okay. So this will be see, we will see in what are the methods by which we can increase this P. Yes, any question? Any query from your side? Please unmute and ask the question if you have any query. So in next class, we will see how to increase P. P what? Vs Vr by x sine delta. So Vr is terminal voltage, Vs is generated voltage or sending in voltage, x is the transmission line. So how many factors P depend? P depend upon generated voltage, receiving end voltage, reactance of the line, and power angle. So we are having a one method, second, third, fourth. So there are four ways by which we can increase P. Okay? Receiving end power. Okay? So compensated by Q. Okay? Q is the main culprit which will deficit, or we can say create problem in P. Okay? Because you have seen S equal to VI conjugate is a function of P and Q. Okay? So you can see after pi by 2, Q is increasing. Okay? So we will never go beyond pi by 2. Okay? It means our torque angle should always be less than 90 degree. We can conclude that delta should be less than 90 degree, okay, for stability point of view. Okay. So in next class we will see the method of reactive power control. Okay. Any question from your side? Please ask. It is visible. Okay, thank you.